Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, everyone. Once again, my name is Father Thomas Tran. I'm in charge of this noon mass in this regional parishes. So welcome to the noon mass. And today, we are in a different location. We are at St. John of the Goods. Regularly, from Monday to Friday, we are at St. Anne's. So today is a new location for me. So I invite you to be attentive to this mass and pray for the end of coronavirus. And today also the church commemorates St. Barnabas, apostle. He also known as apostle who worked with St. Paul to evangelize for the people, especially the pagans and Asia Minor. So let us prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, a great number who believed turned to the Lord. The news about them reached the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to go to Antioch. When he arrived and saw the grace of God, he rejoiced and encouraged them all to remain faithful to the Lord in fullness of heart. For he was a good man, filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. And a large number of people was added to the Lord. Then he went to Tarsus to look for Saul. And when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year, they met with the church and taught a large number of people. And it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. Now, there were in the church of Antioch prophets and teachers: Barnabas, Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, who was a close friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and song. While they were worshipping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then, completing their fasting and prayer, they laid hands on them and sent them off. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
His right hand has won victory for him, his holy hand.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness towards the house of Israel.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise.
The Lord has revealed to the nations.
Praise to the Lord with the harp and melodious song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Sing joyfully before the King, the Lord.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
Jesus said to his disciples, "I tell you, unless the righteousness surpasses that of the scribes and the Pharisees, you will not enter into the kingdom of heaven. You have heard that it was said to your ancestors, 'You shall not kill,' and 'Whoever kills will be liable to judgment.' But I say to you, whoever is angry with his brother will be liable to judgment. And whoever says to his brother, 'Rabbi,' will be answerable to the Sanhedrin. And whoever says, 'You fool,' will be liable to fiery Gehenna. Therefore, if you bring your gift to the altar, and there be called that your brother has anything against you, leave your gift there at the altar. Go first and be reconciled with your brother, and then come and offer your gift. Settle with your opponent quickly while on the way to court with him. Otherwise, your opponent will hand you over to the judge, and the judge will hand you over to the guard, and you will be thrown into prison. Amen, I say to you, you will not be released until you have paid the last penny."
Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have here our Kaya Koji. He's getting ordained deacon next month, July the 4th. So this is a good opportunity for him to deliver some reflections. For now, reflections. Next month will be the homily. So we'll be alternating, I mean, between myself and Kaya Koji. So today's giving the reflection, not the homily.
Brothers and sisters, today we remember the Apostle Barnabas. And he was one of the apostles, as we know, whom Jesus himself chose and then sent out into the world to tell the good news of Jesus' own resurrection and to bring about the kingdom of God. So today, as we think of St. Barnabas, we have great gratitude because the faith from these apostles has even come to us today. So we think in gratitude of St. Barnabas. Now, St. Barnabas was also known for another reason. He can be considered the patron saint of quarrels. Not because he started quarrels, but because he helped resolve quarrels. In the first reading today, we hear how St. Barnabas and Paul meets together to preach in Antioch the same news that Jesus wants to be preached. And they do so together and in unity. But they didn't have the peace between them for the entire time. As we read in the Acts of the Apostles, Paul and Barnabas actually went different ways because of a disagreement in what they should be preaching, that is, on the circumcision. So they actually split up. However, St. Barnabas is known as the patron saint of quarrels because he was able to bring together these two men, St. Barnabas and Paul, in reconciliation. He is a great example of whom we hear in the Gospel, the one who Jesus uses to teach how we should come to God and offer our gifts. We should first find reconciliation with those who we may have hurt or who may have hurt us, because God wants us to offer a pure gift. Now we come here and we gather our minds and our hearts in this holy mass to encounter Christ, who is the Prince of Peace. He is the one who has reconciled us to God. He is the one, because of his peace in our lives, that enables us to be reconciled with others. And he enables us also to be reconciled with ourselves for the ways we may not forgive ourselves for our own sins and failures. And that's why we come today to encounter Jesus Christ, to follow his teaching, to follow the example of St. Barnabas, and to find reconciliation. So during this Mass, as Father Thomas will take bread and wine and consecrate them to become the body and blood of Christ, we also offer our lives on this altar as a gift to God that he might transform us.
Just in the merciful God, we bring our intention before him. We pray for our friends, our Pope, and all our bishops, and all the clergy, with the people entrusted to their charge. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who hold public office, and those who assist them in promoting the common good, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who travel by sea, land, or air, for captives and all held in prison, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the reconciliation between ourselves and ourselves with God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered in this sacred place, by faith and devotion, and by love and reverence for God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the petitions of your church be pleasing in your sight, Lord, so that we may receive from your mercy what we cannot ask out of confidence in our own merits, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Praise, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctify with your blessing, we pray, O Lord,
the offerings presented here, so that by your praise they may set us on fire with the flame of your love, by which Saint Barnabas brought the light of the gospel to the nations, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty and our salvation,
always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, to whom you make all things, whom you send as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, to stretch out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we are glad.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion,
he took bread and giving thanks,
broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up."
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant,
which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins.
Do this in memory of me."
Amen. who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace to our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church." And graciously grant the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
before you, Lord. As what we celebrate in sacramental size on the memorial of the blessed Apostle Barnabas, we may one day be whole and well.
Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. In heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit,
born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again with the dead. From the dead, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand
of God, the Father Almighty.
From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints,
the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life
everlasting.
Amen.
Hail Mary.
We come before you as spiritual children in great need, seeking your intercession and asking that your mantle of love surround us to console, protect, and lead us to your Son, Jesus. We entrust all of God's family, especially the Church in Western Washington, into your immaculate hands. With your Son, Jesus' gentle power, you can undo any knot in our Church and in the lives of believers who entrust themselves to your care. Today, I especially entrust to you the prayer to end the coronavirus, and I ask that, through your intercession and that of St. James, our guardian angels, and the faithful in our archdiocese, we may be free from every spiritual and temporal ill, and be safely led to encounter your Son's merciful, sacred heart. Our Lady of Seattle, undoer of knots, pray for us.